A few weeks ago, I made a video saying that if you own the Wireless Go 1 and you were thinking about purchasing the Wireless Go 2, the Wireless Go 1 was probably good enough considering the cost and the extra features that you may or may not use. But since then, I've changed my mind and I made the move to purchase the Wireless Go 2. And in this video, I'll tell you the reasons why. So let's get it. Hi, I'm Ison Phillips and I do tech reviews, tips, and tutorials about audio, video, and still photography. So if that's something you're into, click on the subscribe button and don't forget to click on the bell notifications so you won't miss future videos. First of all, let's talk about the cost of the Wireless Go 2. I had already made an initial investment of $199 for the Wireless Go 1 and the Wireless Go 2 cost $299. And for me, at least initially, I did not see the cost worth the extra features of the Wireless Go 2. However, there were a lot of little features about the Wireless Go 2 that made it more practical for my use. And so, I put my Wireless Go 1 for sale on eBay. In a few days, my Wireless Go 1 sold for $150 on eBay. So that cut the cost of my Wireless Go 2 in half. Here's just one small reason that I wanted to purchase the Wireless Go 2. I already had a couple of cables that I had purchased with my Rode VideoMic NTG. And with these cables, I'm able to connect my Rode Wireless Go 2 to my laptop without any adapters. I can also connect my Rode Wireless Go 2 to my smartphone, my iPhone, without any adapters. And that may not seem like a big thing, but it makes things a little bit more convenient. Another reason I moved up to the Wireless Go 2, and this may seem like a little thing as well, and it is a little thing, kinda. It's this little thing right here, this little fuzzy thing. Now, if you own the Wireless Go 1, you know what a pain these little things could be. It was hard to lock them into place, and they could fall off while you're using them. With the Wireless Go 2, it's just a twist and this thing locks in place and you can pull on it. It's not going anywhere. That makes things a lot more convenient. Another feature of the Wireless Go 2 that I like is the gain settings. Now, just like the Wireless Go 1, the gain settings are low, medium, and high. But unlike the Wireless Go 1, you can go into the Rode Central app and set the gain settings at the granular level and set them at a decibel level that you require for your recording. Of course, one of the main advantages of having the Wireless Go 2 is having two transmitters. Now, I really don't have a pressing need for having a second transmitter, but it's nice to know it's there if I want to do an interview or if I need to do two-person recording. And it also opens up a world of creative possibilities that I've yet to explore. One advantage of having two transmitters is that you can record each transmitter on a separate track or combine them into one mono track. Also, if you want to mute a transmitter, you can do this at the receiver level, or each transmitter can be muted by pressing the power button once to mute or unmute. This is a great feature to have if one person needs to mute themselves in a conversation. Another feature that's different from the Wireless Go 1 is the distance that you can get between the receiver and the transmitter and still get a clean signal as long as you're in the line of sight. With the Wireless Go 2, that's about 600 feet. Now, you probably will never need to get 600 feet away from the receiver, but what's good to know is that any distance in between there, you know you're going to get a good clean signal. Of course, by now you've probably heard that the transmitters with the Wireless Go 2 are capable of recording, and you can get up to 40 hours of uncompressed audio on each transmitter and up to 17 hours of compressed audio on each transmitter. I think initially it was 7 hours of uncompressed audio, but with the firmware update, it went up to 17 hours. And that's a great feature to have, and it's one that you may not use. I don't always use it, but it's nice to know if I need it and I have that backup recording, that if anything goes wrong, I have that recording to go back and fix it. So yeah, a lot of features with the Wireless Go 2 you may not use right away, but there may be a time in the future where you will need it and you'll be glad that you have it. Going back to my original video where I said the Wireless Go 1 was good enough for most users, I'll stand by that. If you have the Wireless Go 1 and it's working for you, there's no need to upgrade to the Wireless Go 2. But in this video, I wanted to show you a few things that I'd consider to be worthwhile for me to upgrade to the Wireless Go 2. And you may think about those things as well. If you have the Wireless Go 1 and it's working for you, there's no need to upgrade. It's a great piece of gear. It gives you good audio quality and it's simple to use. But if you need a little bit more, or you think you may need a little bit more in the future, you may want to consider the Wireless Go 2. If you have questions or comments about the Wireless Go 1 or the Wireless Go 2, leave them below. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful, and consider subscribing if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, everyone. We will see you in the next video.